Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. It's early in the morning, about 5:40 a.m. on day 5. We have not received any letters and we don't have a main quest, but we do have a side quest. We need to go to the town hall and see what we can do about the whole situation with Soborov rounding up tons of civilians and arresting them. Because apparently he was kind of driven a bit crazy and got a bit zealous in his attempts to stop the criminals that have been wandering around town with knives. So we need to go see if we can deal with that. But before we go to the town hall, let's also catch up with some people along the way. Let's go speak with Ava. And I'm thinking after Ava, I'll probably go to Baby Vlad's place and see if I can get the updated infection map. Yeah. Let's go get the updated infection map. After talking to Ava. And I'm sure we'll receive a letter for today pretty soon. Usually comes early in the morning, I think. How are my stats looking, by the way? Forgot to check. Health, good, immunity, good, hunger, pretty good, exhaustion, infection. Yeah, I'm good on everything, really.
Yes?
Nothing new to say. Yep, nothing new.
What?
Let's see what her voices are for the day, her little voice lines.
What do you need to take to avoid catching it? My bedroom is warmer than this place.
Oh yeah, was I thinking about dumping stuff in storage since I have so many things? I think I was thinking about doing that. But I don't think I will. Because I know my inventory is almost full, I think. We've got a bit of time, so I'm going to go back to looting. I'll go at least a little bit out of my way to loot some containers. That means it must be 6 a.m. now. I'm also going to more diligently hunt for bandages, so let's speak with this person up here. Hello, Max Payne. Ooh, right, there's going to be new dialogue for some of the people. I think this is new. Oh, how ferocious mother... Wait. No, I've read this before. What are you mumbling there? Town is dying, for it's written, water shall become blood like that of a dead man. Is this... I feel like I've asked about this before, but I'm not entirely sure. Let's just assume I haven't seen this before. Water shall become blood like that of a dead man. True. Blood spills faster than water. And the body shall be desecrated, and the children shall rise up against their parents. Tell me about the Backbone District. Where is it? Any points of interest there? It's in the knots by the wall. That's where the town hall is. The common opinion goes that it's the most useless district of them all. A district of dimwits. My pa, rest his soul in peace, used to say just that. A district of dimwits. Never allowed little me to be there so that I wouldn't pick their stupidity up. Oh, and I can just straight up insult them. Let's not do that. Really, your father seems like a most honorable person. He was a sot, so help me. A thief and a waste of skin. Cursed like a she-dog. Drank away all our money. And ruined my pure-hearted ma through his wretchedness. The son is a success, though. Would you like to barter? Ah, no bandages. Dang. Bad guy. And that is the direction I need to go to get to Little Vlad's place. You are gonna die. Actually, you know what? Nah. You can chase me all you want. Chase me all the way to Vlad's door. I think he maybe lost me. Yeah, he did. Or got stuck on something.
Interest speaks all sorts of tongues and plays all kinds of characters, even that of disinterest.
Tonight, the patrols were grabbing anyone who looked even remotely suspicious. 2 dozen people were arrested just for having a knife or other weapon in their possession. Many were taken for not giving out Yaklok's accomplices, others for looting the dead or their homes. I know, I've talked to Victor Kane. Oh, and what does he say? He thinks the innocent deserve to be freed. I want to bribe the executor guards and free some of those people. Would you be willing to help me? Oh my god. That's very serious. That's very serious. If Sobrov finds out that I did that, that I bribed some guards and freed some of the people that he had arrested, he is never going to trust me again. Well, I guess there's no harm in saying yes and then deciding not to do it, right? I mean, I want to go there first and maybe get Sobarov's... get his viewpoint before I go crazy. Although I doubt there's anything he could say that would persuade me to think that he didn't do something wrong. But, alright, I'll take it for now. With pleasure. An unexpected gesture from you, though. What's your motive? Duty. I don't readily sympathize with people, regardless of which side of the bars they're on. But I feel responsible for any acts committed by those with power. It is my duty to undo and compensate at least a fraction of the damage inflicted by the law enforcer's incompetence. I doubt Sobarov will approve of your actions when he finds out.
Why is no one being buried?
Being locked up in jail equals being sent to the gallows in the current situation. Both spell imminent death. That's true. If you're stuck in jail with an infected person, Jesus Christ, that's dangerous. They're all gonna become infected. You're dead. So you're having your people chart the infection hotspots on a regular basis now, aren't you? I would like to have a look. I'll sell you a map at a big discount. Almost for free. It'll only be 1,000. Yes, we've already talked about this. It's always been 1,000. I wonder if I can talk him down to lower. Even though I have a lot of money, I'm gonna see if I can talk him down lower. Are you joking? I'm barely scraping by. Okay, he just doesn't give a shit. He has no sympathy.
Folly is not...
Yes, that's a very modest price when compared to the food shops, is what I meant to say before. Alright, what are we looking at for today? Oh. The whole warehouse district is infected, huh? This region was uninfected before. It became reinfected? So it used to be this was uninfected, this it had died out here, and this was infected, and this was infected. Now this is reinfected, now these are uninfected, and it spread here, to these two places. I wonder if it's going to continue that day by day. You skip, you know, maybe tomorrow these places that are red will become uninfected, and the places that are black will become reinfected? How did it get reinfected, though? It's most curious. Most curious indeed. Perhaps if I'd collected the house ninja's belongings and taken it to Sabarov, it wouldn't have happened. Alright, well, I don't want to run out of time again. So I think from here I'm gonna head straight to the town hall and just start doing the side quest. Maybe stop by Olgimsky's place along the way. Yeah, let's stop by Olgimsky's place along the way. That sounds good. And I can't wait for the children to come out because I have so many things to trade. I see somebody running in the distance. Ah, freaking murderer is murdering somebody. Asshole. I'm coming. Hold on, gonna save some ammo here. Got him. Unfortunately, once again, in my attempt to save ammo, I allowed this person to get killed. Thankfully, nobody saw that. I'm sorry, sir. Should I speak to Reuben while I'm here? I feel like I should speak to Reuben every day about the progress of the plague. I don't want to go into an infected region, but I am very close to Reuben. Let's do it. I'm not going to go to Bad Grief. I'll just go to Reuben. Let's see if the guards have anything to say. Off limits. Off limits. Blah, blah, blah. Oh yeah, let's barter actually. I forgot. You have... Ooh. Revolver ammo. Oh, but it costs 2. I can get it for 1 from children. That's not worth it. And food costs 5. Now smoked meat costs 7, but vegetables cost 5. Oh, a crowbar can actually be used to barter. Cool, cool. 5 razors for 1 can of vegetables? Don't know if that's worth it. Nope, I don't need to do- Oh, shit. Whew, that was close. Can I get around you? Oh, seriously? It looked like I was clear. So you just can't come in this way then, huh? If you want to avoid the infection? Alright. That's fine, my infection's still... Yeah, my infection's not too high, it's okay. Mind of its own. Well, Reuben, I guess you got plenty of fresh samples around here, huh?
I'm on my last legs. I can't take it anymore.
You're here at last. Damn my position. I have no choice but to hide from the townsfolk, see? I understand their anger, but they have armed search parties to hunt me down, as if I were spreading the plague rather than trying my best to stop it. You do know what they... I think I should say you do know why they incriminate you, right? They say you have desecrated Simon's remains. Frankly, I'm surprised you haven't been discovered yet. Yeah, really. I'm really surprised. They're too afraid of Bad Grief's thugs. Ironically, it is they who volunteered to protect me from honest townsfolk. Search parties swinging firearms and torches have passed through the northern warehouses a few times. That was close. But I think I'm off the hook for now. Thankfully, I've kept this place a secret from anyone, save for my apprentices. But there are some people that know, right? Doesn't, Big Vlad? No, I think he knows. Because I remember trying to convince him at one point not to tell the Canes where, Reuben is. So you've got them at least, right? Two of them did come to help me. I haven't seen either of them since yesterday. I think they've fallen sick, but they managed to get a lot done the other day. I was even able to conduct some tests. I see you had a productive day yesterday. Oh yes. We won't be able to produce a full-fledged vaccine in these conditions, true, but with a little bit of luck, we'll succeed to make a reliable preventative formula. Admittedly, the effect of the injection won't last longer than 10 hours or so. Still, if it proves effectual, many lives will be saved. So a full-fledged vaccine is out of the question? Unfortunately, I'm not that good at chemistry. A vaccine would call for someone less crude. The reagents I'm used to wouldn't ruin the source specimen. I'm lucky to have my teacher's solutions, at least. They proved to be useful. On the other hand, I've almost figured out how the vaccine may be compounded. I can almost write down the formula. How is it compounded, then? That depends on the results of the further tests. Hopefully, we'll be able to run them today. What exactly are you going to test today, then? As you undoubtedly remember, our first attempt at making a vaccine involved a microbe that was already dead. To this, the organism produced almost no immune reaction. In our second attempt, we had a weakened microbe to experiment with. Weakened by, well, you know how. The third vaccine, then, should be made on the basis of a living specimen. The bacterium dies when extracted from a life-sustaining environment. Do we need to collect a portion of infected blood from someone who is still alive? Something along those lines. Brace yourself, Bachelor. We need a human heart. A heart that is still alive and beating. This is the meat that will make our curative broth. Why can't we just bring an infected person here and collect their blood? I tried it already. Didn't you say the bacterium dies along with the blood cells? It is even more drastic than that. The microbe survives for mere moments in its pure state. It splits, it converts the blood cells, and it dies. However, a heart muscle... How do you mean, its pure state? What I mean is, the state the bacterium is in when the immune system begins to fight it. There are several stages of the microbe development. We need to nail down the intermediate one. But what does a living heart have to do with all this? If the sickness spreads to the heart, it makes a kind of colony there. I know it may sound ridiculous. I'm not really a scientist, I merely recall the observations I made. An infected heart would allow us to extract the bacteria at its most pure, most potent state, provided we work fast enough. Fast enough? Why don't we just bring an infected person here and take as many blood samples as needed, one after another? That won't do. The infection must have progressed to an irreversibly critical state. Whoever carries it would be in agony by the time. We don't have to cut the patient up right here, though. I believe we have about 30 minutes to bring the heart to here from wherever it is obtained. Okay, what if you take a dog or a rat? Like, what about one of the plague rats? Some of my associates have tried it already. No point whatsoever. Human organisms will not produce antibodies to fight animal infections. Our enemy is sly as the devil himself. It's as if the disease wanted us to take this symbolic step. Jesus Christ. It is becoming obvious that there's something very wrong with this plague, beyond just the mere fact of its existence, beyond the mere fact that there is a plague that's killing people. There's something extra wrong with it. The fact that it dies out so quickly, but then apparently, based on the plague map I just got, can just suddenly come back just as suddenly. The fact that it's so hard to isolate and to even find it just disappears so quickly. once the host dies. Almost as if it's like a soul that just possesses the person. And then as soon as they die, the soul travels somewhere else or something like that. And also the fact that it chases you down. Those clouds. Some of those clouds will come after you. It seems alive in a way beyond just the fact that it's a bacteria that's alive. But it seems like thinking, as if it's intelligent. I don't know. It's very strange and creepy. And there's something very wrong about it. Almost as if the plague is more symbolic than literal. But obviously there's a literal side to it, because hundreds of people are dying. You've done a bloody great deal, my dear colleague. So have your associates, however scarce they were. Young Brock offered his help. He was going to dissect the dying anyway, but he's already more than 6 hours late, so I'm forced to request your assistance. If we're unable to find Brock, you'll have to perform the grisly task yourself. Brock was going to dissect the people while they were still alive. I'd like you to know that he is set to achieve a rather noble feat. He wants to duplicate his father's success. While we were busy trying to protect the healthy, he wants to make a concoction that will enable him to cure the sick. He calls it a panacea. Reportedly, he's made quite a bit of progress on it. So he will have no reservation about cutting the heart out of a living person? The steppe people are like that, Doctor. You don't seem to quite understand the difference between you and them. They're barely daunted with things that would scare us to death. The blood of a steppe person belongs to the earth. One way or another, Barak will be working in the infected quarters today. Won't he be torn apart for desecrating the dead? Quite possibly. As his father's successor, he is empowered to open up bodies. But his succession is not necessarily acknowledged by simple townsfolk, so he's putting himself at risk. Still, he'll be dissecting the living today. This is a one-of-a-kind opportunity for us to get what we need. What am I supposed to do if Barak refuses to help? You'll have to keep an eye on him, then. If he's discovered, he will have to run for his life, serving as an effective decoy. No one will concern themselves with what remains of his seance. Sneak up on a corpse he cut, grab the heart, and bring it to me as soon as possible. The blood has to be warm. Jesus Christ, am I going to agree to do this? I mean, I guess if it's progressed to the point. He says, what Ruben has said is that he needs a heart from somebody who has progressed to the critical stage of the infection, which means there's no real curing it at that point, right? So, are we not just doing them a favor, putting them out of their agony by killing them? But is it true that even if you're at the critical state, there's no going back? What about the schmouter stuff I have that's supposed to completely cure you of the infection? I don't know. I guess I'll take it. We'll see whether I actually do it, though. Well, what can I say? It does seem to be a unique opportunity. Big Vlad provided patronage to Isidore Brock's son, that foolhardy surgeon. He has to know where to find the man. Okay, perfect. I was gonna head there next anyway. Yep, can go there, figure out where young Brock is, hopefully, on my way to the town jail. I feel like I'm gonna get to the town jail and everybody is gonna be dead. I mean, the infection's in the zone. So,
I hope Sephiroth and his bloody manhood.
Doing everything I can. The victory is near, colleague. Kindly wipe that smirk off your face. You won't have to wait long now. I hope so. Okay, so that gives me two side quests, right? Oh. No, this is actually the main quest. Interesting. Wow, so I actually just discovered the main quest without even having been sent a letter. Cool. That feels good. Well, if that's the main quest for today, then I guess I'm going to have to do it. If I've got to cut someone's heart out or take the heart that's already been cut, I guess I'll do it. Let's see if I can find a safer way out of here. Yeah, I think if I just go straight. If I just go straight, there should be a way out. Oh my god, there's a cloud blocking that way too. Okay, so this exit is blocked by a cloud. That exit is blocked by a cloud. That only leaves two other exits, but that's kind of far away. I don't want to waste that much time. Shit. I don't think I can sneak by it. Fuck! Is there anything I can jump on? Total death toll, 430 people. You cannot fight this. It all ends in less than 8 days. Day 5, in which the bachelor regrets his affection for the living and would very much prefer to like the dead. Oh god. Okay, do I eat the infection? Do I eat the infection and run through the cloud, or do I try to go around it and waste time? It's early in the morning. I guess I'm just gonna waste time. And we could go talk to Bad Grief along the way, see if he has anything new to say. Alright, that's fine, I guess. Oh, great. Not stopping. Freaking plague rats. They're a pain in the heels. Ooh! Oh, fuck. This does not go to... Oh, fuck! I think I might be able to safely get out there, possibly. But, I meant to hit Bad Grief's lair first so I can ditch the plague rat. This place, right? Yes, thank god. Oh, plague rat ditched. I think I just received a letter. I did! Anna Angel's invitation. Bachelor. As I sat down to remember the horrors I had to endure yesterday, a scintillating idea occurred to me. A tiny affair, really. Nothing to talk of. No troubles. No undercurrents. No strings attached. Nothing. Not a trifling. But if it comes to pass, we will both come into a spectacular amount of money. What are you waiting for? Hurry to the willows. P.S. Please don't tell anyone about this letter. P.P.S. Don't ever speak of our affairs in public. P.P.P.S. Keep strictly incognito. Respectfully, A.A.A. Interesting. Intriguing. I can't say money's exactly in the forefront of my mind, especially since I've actually got a really good amount of money right now. But if I ever run out, I'm gonna be screwed. So, sure, I'll go speak with her.
Where there's carrion, there are crows.
Anna, the precious little singing bird of ours, has been so lively and so kicking lately. Now she wants to bail my villain folks out of jail. And the bail's supposed to be real fat. It is, so she must know where to get a lot of monies. 10 lives are worth at least some coins, eh? Even them villain lives. The lovely beaut must be in a serious need of a hit on someone, I figure. A hit? Villains? What villains are you talking about? Our good lads are doing the languishing in the town hall. They got the wrong people yesterday, they did. Missed the point completely. And Anna, the dove of love that she is all up and ready to pay real gold for them captive villains, only to have them do her bidding. And the dove of love is right, she is. We'll dance to the tune of the lad, or lass, who shells out the coin. That is what gratitude means. It's ironic that I just read the letter right before speaking to Bad Grief. So Anna wants me to help with that, obviously. And her plan is to actually gain control of them. But then what? What is she gonna do with them? Her group of villains. I don't actually want to say this, but it seems like the best option. Let them just serve the time there for a while. What's the rush? So rumor has that there's an Inquisitor up and coming straight towards our little town, eh? Well, I don't have the guts to stand up to an Inquisitor. And I definitely won't have any after he's done with us lot. Neither will my lads. We'd rather dive an honest bullet straight between our eyes than expire on a torture rack after a week. What do you think? Maybe Bad Grief would give me some of the money to bail them out? Or is it Anna that's going to be giving the money to bail them out? Well, regardless, do I want to bail them out? It sounds like they weren't arrested for a good reason, even if they are villains, even if they are bad people. But Bad Grief's people are apparently not the ones that have been killing people. So maybe they're not that bad. Okay, fine. Have to bail your villains out. You'd have our most eternal gratitude, Doc. Kind services on our part included. We'd rather do your bidding than die trying to execute the stupid wench's revenge. Wait, what revenge? Annis, eh? She's beside herself. The little snake is. She can't wait to get to someone. Trust me, Doc, I can smell it. The dove of love is dying to peck a heart out. What a strange... That is such a strange choice of words, Bad Grief. The dove of love is dying to peck a heart out. And it just so happens that I need a heart. That is very suspicious. Could just be a coincidence. This game's so wonderfully poetic sometimes. Like, the dove of love is dying to peck a heart out. That's so grim, but so... just so creepy. Calling her a dove and then running with the image of her being a dove and saying she's gonna peck someone's heart out. The fact that I also need a heart from a living person. Just... ugh. I'll go see Anna. Hopefully I'll see what this is all about.
For the usualist.
What have you got to sell? I could actually almost afford the rifle. But I really don't need it. I do kind of need ammo. But it's not worth 900. I'd rather just trade with the children for it. Jesus Christ. 30,000 for repellent jackboots. I am not going to buy anything. I still can't talk to you, right? Nope. Okay, get the hell out of here and go to Olgimski. See if we can find a good way out of here. Okay, so this way I can actually get out safely. You know, it's been a long time since I've been down here. To the chieftain's place. What the hell? What's the worst that could happen? Actually, a lot of bad stuff could happen. But it seriously has been a long time. For some reason, I can't use my view scope thing. I don't know if it, like, has a... Yeah, there we go. Oh, the bar at the bottom of it's actually almost gone. I guess it needs to, like, regenerate or something. I don't know. Gotta be careful, though. How's it going, children? In fact, I don't believe I've been here since, like, the first couple days of the game, I think.
I see double or something.
And there's still no reason to talk with you. Alright, that was a waste of time. It's okay, it's 7:30 in the morning. We're good. Okay, too old, Gimski. Go straight, hang a right as soon as we're past the warehouses. Back to relative peace. Everything is fine. There's nothing to worry about. You may wish to make sure your revolver is loaded, but remember there's nothing to worry about. Just relax. You've got all the time in the world. Gimski, so I need a heart.
Lucky people are bad hands at correcting their faults. They always believe that they're right when fortune backs up their vice or folly.
My girl has grown up. I pray she survives this hell. That's right, I was supposed to inspect the termitary today. I forgot about that. And... Wow, this is a creepy line. I'm rather fond of your daughter myself. Let's not say that. That's creepy. Well, the termitary is not my main quest for the day, so let's go with Barak. Do you know where Barak is hiding? Oh, I thought you two didn't really get along. Are you looking for him? Yes, I sorely need to find him. Then you'll be most unhappy to learn that he's been seized on Sabarov's orders. I was informed by Lara Ravel about it. A witness of Barak's arrest came by to her place. Seized? Why? A groundless suspicion. Many innocent people were arrested and thrown into the dungeons of the town hall last night. Barley and his barbers caused quite a stir yesterday. A stir that has made quite an impression on Sabarov. And so, he resorted to harsh punitive measures. Everything goes exactly as expected. This is his first step towards autocracy. What is Barak being accused of? I don't know. But I have absolutely no doubt it's a false accusation. Artemy has been accused of every possible villainy lately. They call him the Ripper. They cry bloody murder while he works his fingers to the bone trying to save us all. But no one cares about it at all. God damn it, Sabarov. Sabarov is messing everything up now. I'll demand that Sabarov let him go. Give it a try, dear doctor. Artemy deserves it. Even if he has taken it upon himself to break a law or two, we need him alive. Perhaps if you vouched for him, the fierce Sabarov would let him go. Oh, what a grave mistake it was to grant him full authority. Your mistake, Doctor. Spare me your reprimands. Do you think it was I who gave him the power? I guess he has nothing to say to that. Alright, gotta go speak with Sabarov. I guess I should speak with Sabarov before going to the jail, right? Yeah. What order should I do this in? I'm thinking the town jail is probably the last place I should go. I should talk with Lara. Because she saw them seize Artemy, or young Barak. And I should speak with Sabarov himself, too. Let's go to Lara first. And?
What is that blunderhead found in the well? Oh, the fool.
Wait, you just said, what is that blunderhead found in the well? What well? Which one? The one behind the cathedral? Assuming that is a well? Was that a well? I don't know. It was locked, whatever it was. But anyway, yes, I need to get into the termitary. What for? I can describe everything you can possibly see there verbally. Just think of a ward full of demented people, multiply it 100-fold, add the sand plague, and there you go. That's the termitary. I'm bound by duty. No, Doctor. Even if the sand plague is merciful to you, the inhabitants of the termitary will not extend similar kindness. You are our last hope. The only doctor that hasn't succumbed to despair and is still fighting. Risking your life would be the last thing I would do. Even if that meant becoming the next victim of Sabarov's abuse. He might be right, but goddamn do I not trust him. I want to see for myself. I'm afraid I have to insist. Bose, or however you say that. The termitary is a graveyard of its own. An educated risk is one thing. Lying down into a grave and giving an order to start filling it up is different. Although the latter seems to be the safer option than delving into the termitary. Does that mean no? I will get there sooner or later anyway. Better later than sooner, then, for every spare hour will add to your chances. One day, you'll be forced to. No one will force me to unlock the termitary. Definitely not Sabarov, that's for sure. Even if he tries, I would rather accept the blow. No, Doctor. The doors of the termitary shall not be open to you for as long as I'm in control. Just accept the fact, dear Doctor. I do not accept that, Vlad. And perhaps what you say is true, though. Perhaps they will never open as long as you're in control. But perhaps you won't be in control for long. You've got a ready tongue? Let's go see if his daughter has anything new to say. Haven't spoken with her in a while, and she's just right here.
It's the same power that my dear mother used to glimmer with.
Nope, nothing new. Okay, make sure I haven't missed anything. I've got Anna Angel's invitation, yes. I have a side quest and my main quest. I need to speak with Anna. She lives here. Now would not be a terrible time to visit Anna. I could go across the bridge right here. Yeah, you know what? Let's do it. Let's go speak with Anna right now. Ah, but then again, after speaking with Anna, the next logical person to talk to is Sobrov, and I don't want to talk to Sobrov until I've spoken with Lara, because I want as much evidence as I can get before coming to Sobrov. Because if I'm going to convince him that what he did was wrong, or convince him to release people or something, I want to be armed with as much information as possible. So yeah, you know what, let's actually go to Lara first. I changed my mind. Let's avoid the infected region. No reason we have to go through it. At least not yet. Wouldn't mind getting some more food. Although I think my food is pretty good. Yeah, my hunger's not bad. It's halfway though, so it wouldn't hurt to eat. Oh, milk? That's all you've got? Oh, this is where I bought food last episode, actually. That's why he's got nothing left. Except this time, I'm not gonna forget to go to Lara's place. Where are the frickin' children? It's 8:22. I thought they would have been out by now. Whoa! Two guards chasing a villain and a villain chasing a woman. And now the guard's stuck on the water pump. Nice. Alright, Lara, how are you doing? Well, you're not dead yet. That's good.
Aruspex has cut a butcher open. This time it's for sure he's been seen.
We're still alive? How very strange. Aww. Lara, please tell me, is the man who witnessed Barak's arrest still here? You mean the harpist? He's dead. What were his words? That his only final wish was to eat a handful of large raspberries. That shouldn't be funny, but for some reason it is. No, I meant about Barak's arrest. Did he say anything about where he was taken? He saw them escort him, nothing more. It was by the rail bridge. He was seized by Sobarov's patrolmen. There were three of them, and yet they barely managed to keep him under control. When they were crossing the embankment, Barak broke loose, so they knocked him to the ground. The harpist said he also thought back then that they wouldn't be able to take him anywhere far, and then he felt sick. Why are the Subarovs doing that to him? I think he got into Clara's way somehow. This Clara girl seems pretty scary. I guess Artemy must have disrupted her plans, and I doubt she was planning to do good. As for Barak, on the other hand, his noble intentions are apparent. How is she scary? I can't tell if she's a healer or a killer. It's so confusing. But she's definitely unkind. Everything about her is just so suspicious. You know, sometimes I think it was she who made the harpist die. The man who brought the news of Barak's arrest. Did he have business with Barak? He got it into his head that he's supposed to help Barak in any way he could. He only came by here to grab the bare essentials, and said Artemy was the only person worth giving one's life for. But in the end, his body just gave in. What about you? Do you like Barak? He turned out to be a very impressive person. The semblance to his father is so strong. I can't help thinking about him. Indeed. He's an honest and brave man. You too would have made good friends. So Barak's lair was at the works? I don't know. I've never been there. Although, Isidore did have a hideout or a secret lab at the works. I remember him complaining that he was too old to climb over the embankment 10 times a day. Where's the works? Climbing over the embankment. Hmm? Thank you, Lara. Now I know where to look for Barak. Do I? Apparently I do.
My lips are too dry. What do you need to take to avoid infection?
So they didn't actually mark anything on my map, right? Nope. But it did add something to the quest. Barak is somewhere in the works. There are quite a few separate workshops there. With all the information I've collected, finding him shouldn't be that much trouble. Where's the works? I disagree, game. I think finding him might be a bit difficult, because I don't even know where the works is. I mean, I would just assume it's somewhere here. Somewhere in the warehouses, but I don't know. Climbing over the embankment. Hell if I know. Jesus Christ, this is gonna take all day, isn't it? This is gonna be my time waster for the day. It's gonna eat up all of my time. Well, that'll be fun. I can already see that's gonna be really frustrating and just soul-destroying to do. Any quest where you don't know exactly where to go and you have to search, that sucks, because that feeling of uncertainty, of not knowing how much time you're gonna have to spend, it just feels bad. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to go speak with Sabarov about the whole thing with the town jail and Barak and all that, and then I will probably head over to Anna Angel's place and see what her proposal is.